they begin to tell you examples of people that have done it in the past. But that others have done it in the past and they did not succeed does not mean that you will not succeed.
Praise God. This is your friend, Emmanuel Adegbola. I want to welcome you to this month of June, the sixth month in the year 2017. Stretch forth your hands. Let me pray with you. I want to release prophetic blessing for the month of June over your destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you for your daughter. I thank you for your son. Thank you for this person listening or watching this program right now. Oh, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, I thank you for what you have planned for them. You said in your word that for your thought towards us is not a thought of evil, but of good, to give us an expected end. Father, I pray concerning your son, concerning your daughter's expectation from the month of June, Jehovah mighty God, you will fulfill, you will meet them at the point of their destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. God of heaven will surprise you this month of June. I pray for pleasant surprises in the mighty name of Jesus. God will locate you and favor you. Your destiny helpers, the Lord will connect you with them in the mighty name of Jesus. You are blessed in Jesus' mighty name. I have prayed and decreed. Amen. If you receive that and you believe it, say amen 3 times. I receive it. Hallelujah. Yes, you don't have to fall down. It's not when you fall down that you know that your prayers have been answered. Every prayer I pray for you, the Lord Almighty will give you answer in the mighty name of Jesus, and there will be testimony. I am made, I am sent because of you. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Yes, we started the series of training on Keep On Sowing about 3 weeks ago. And we're going to be finishing right now, this week, and be blessed as you watch this in the mighty name of Jesus. And do us a favor, share this video with somebody. Don't be selfish. If this video, if this training series, if this teaching series is blessing you, then share with somebody. It's not about me, it's not about anybody, it's just about Christ. And it's about that message of hope that we bring to this world. Okay, share with somebody. Then we started a program in our church, in our parish yesterday. We call it 10 Insightful Sundays to Demystify Financial Empowerment. In order for you to serve God without pain, without agony, without bitterness, you need to be financially empowered. And that is why in the next 10 weeks, we're going to be looking into how to empower yourself in this generation, in this era, in this third millennium. How to empower yourself. You need to be financially empowered in order for you to even do the work of God successfully. So, if you find yourself in our neighborhood, we invite you to worship with us. God bless you as you come in the mighty name of Jesus. So, let's finish the series, Keep On Sowing. You are blessed in Jesus' name. Amen. Grace to go for it again. God Almighty will give to you in the mighty name of Jesus.
This is your time. This is your season. I release it on God this week and prosper.
So, he was an ambitious sower. Then point number 3. What is point number 1? Is the key to all the parables based on the law of sowing and reaping. The second one is that the sower was what? Ambitious. Then the third one, this sower had an excellent seed. Praise the Lord. He had an excellent seed. People of God, I want to believe that the seed he was sowing was not just one seed. It was not just one seed. Because if it was just, assuming it was just only one corn, one seed of a corn that he wanted to plant. And immediately he planted it, and of course he fell on the stony ground, and it did not grow, that is the end of it. It tells for me that this sower did not rely on just one stream of income. He had many of them. So when one fails, the other ones are still functioning. I know there are millions of sermons on these parables. Praise the Lord. Amen. He had excellent seed. This excellent seed could mean excellent opportunity. This excellent seed could mean excellent business ideas. This excellent seed could mean an income stream. This excellent seed, according to the interpretation of the parable in the word of God, could mean the word of God. Jesus says, and the seed is the word of God. You preach to somebody, the person says, okay, I will be in the church, and he did not show up, but you do not stop there. You keep on praying for that person. You keep on preaching. We keep on sharing the trust. We keep on doing what God asks us to do. The question is, what kind of seed do you have in your hand? When God gives us our daily bread, when God provides for us, when God provides that job for you, when God gives you that business ideas and establishes that business for you, God normally provides both the seed and the bread. Yes, we normally pray, give me my daily bread. But God does not give only the bread. He will provide the seed and he will provide the bread. He will give the bread to the eater. That's what the Bible says. Then he provides the seed for the sower. So you are not supposed to eat the bread and eat the seed. But what most of us, what we do is we eat the bread, we eat the seed. If possible, if we see somebody that is still holding on to his own seed, we don't even mind grabbing it and eat it. 2 Corinthians 9:10 says, now he, talking about God, he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will supply and multiply your seed. You see? And supply and multiply your seed for sowing and increase the harvest of your righteousness. When we need yam, we plant yam. When we need tomato, people of God, we plant tomato. When you need money, you are supposed to plant money, sow money. These are part of teachings that we don't want to hear in the church these days. We can so prayer, there's a place for prayer, but there's a place for sowing. When we had the twins, when God gave us the twins, we did not buy diaper for the first almost 7 or 8 months. Almost 9 months, almost a year. We did not buy diaper. We did not buy wipes. Why? Because when I was here, before my wife came, anybody that gave birth, what I used to do, I would buy a box of diapers and a box of wipes. And that's what I would give to them. When my wife came, anybody that is doing baby dedication, naming ceremony, we got a box of diapers and a box of wipes. To me, that's what I think is the easiest thing you could. So, when we had the twins, they loaded us with boxes of diapers and boxes of our wipes. Then I told my wife, I said, I think we've got enough of diapers and enough of wipes. I told her, I said, anytime anybody put to bed around us and we have to go and visit, I said, I think I need money. So we'll be sowing money. It doesn't matter how much it is, then we'll sow it. It might be $20, it might be $50, it might be $100, but we don't buy things most of the time again. Even if we give things like dress or whatever, we still have to envelope something and give with it. Because we need money. Praise the Lord. What you sow is what you reap. Was it Daddy Gio or Mike Mudok that was sharing one time where he looked at his closet and it was full of ties, neckties. So no wonder. Because any pastor that came to minister in their church, all he used to do is buy tie and give them ties. And trust me, God of law of sowing and reaping. People know that his life with tithe. That he narrated what he used to get. that one way or the other, he will say, okay, God, enough of this. I will start sowing another thing. Today, now people are talking that he has a flock of cars. Why would he? When somebody bought a very brand new car and he gave it away, he sold it. Then today, God is blessing him with so many of them. Then people that did not see when you are sowing, that's when you will see them frowning their faces. Mm. The outcome, is it only him? Is it only her? But they did not know where you are sowing. Mm. They don't need to know anyway. You don't even need to announce yourself when you are doing the sowing. Mm. But sow anyway. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So anyway, God provides seed for the sower and bread for the eater. You are not supposed to eat the bread and also eat the seed. Point number four. The sower never quit. He never quit. Due to the circumstances and challenges that surrounded him in that parable, he had many reasons to quit. Bible says that the birds get some of the seed that he planted. He had reason to say, yeah, I planted anyway, but the birds got them. May I tell somebody here that the birds will get some? Who are the birds? They are the Sambalat, they are the Tobias. We go on evangelism, we preach, we share tracts, we see somebody, we are with a lot of energy. They said they will be in church, maybe they show up the first time. We are so happy, we receive them, we pray with them. Before you know it, second Sunday you don't see them. Third Sunday you don't see them. Fourth Sunday you don't see them. The birds will get some. Those birds, it might be internal conflict. Those birds can be a place of rest. That's what is called danger of rest. When you are too comfortable, dangers of comfort zone. When you are too comfortable. So, note that when you are sowing, the birds will get some. You are trusting God for fruit of womb, the birds will get some. That is why it's not all the sperms that fertilize the egg. Because if that should happen, it means by the time a woman is going to give birth, you'll be giving birth to millions of children at the same time. Praise the Lord. So, the birds will get some. Then, when the birds get some, you have two choices, according to Jim Rohn. It's either you go to the field and you keep chasing the birds. You keep chasing the birds. You keep chasing the birds. Or you just make up your mind to keep sowing. Because when you keep sowing, you persevere. When you keep sowing, it will get to a time that the birds will not have enough to grab hold of. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And may I tell somebody, it will always do. Because then another law will step in place. And it is called the law of average. It's called the law of average. When you do something long enough, the law of average will step in. When we go out there, we invite somebody. They come, one came, two came, three came. Out of, sometimes it will be like maybe 10 people visit the church. Before you know it, one out of 10 stay. We begin to nurture that one. We continue. We keep sowing the seed, which is the word of God, which is tracts, which is our video that we do weekly, which is, you know, praying for people, following up, doing all sorts of things. Before you know it, another 10 come. One stay, right? Yes, to you, statistically, you'll be looking at, 20 people visited our church. How come is two? Mathematically speaking, what you are having is you are having 10% return on your investment. If you read that scripture, it says some did 30%, some did 60%, we'll get there. And some did what? 100. When you invest $100,000 in bank, how much do you get? Do you have investors in the house? how much do you get, let's say monthly or yearly, on that investment?
You get like 20% of it.
You get like 20% of it. And what is 20% of, let's say, $10,000?
Yeah.
Or let's say, let's round it up. Let's shoot ourselves. Let's dream big. Okay. You invest $1 million in the bank and you have 20% interest on it. So how much is that? 20% of 1 million? About 200,000. So, and somebody say, how come you invested $1 million and you get $200,000 in a whole year, but you get 20% back? You can invest in some things, you will get 6%. Some you can get more than that. It depends on what you invest on. There's high risk investment and there's lower risk investment. Praise the Lord. So the same thing in the house of God, in the things of God. And that is why Jesus was talking right there. He said, some will bring 30%. So, we're talking about law of average. When you sow, when we have 10 and one stay, we have another 10, one stay. How many do we have? Two. A time is coming, we'll begin to do some feedback. Why is it that 9 doesn't stay? It's only one. We begin to learn some things that make the first one stay, the second one stay. Praise the Lord. Before you know it, 10 will come and 2 will stay. What happens? We are getting what? Better. So, we now grow from 10% to 20%. That is what is called what? The law of average. But you don't quit while you are sowing. In your life, you don't quit. You apply for this job. They don't take you. You go for interview. The way they ask questions, you don't say because they did not hire you on that job, then you will quit applying. You still keep what? Sowing. You are trusting God for fruit of womb. You did it the first time. I remember when we were trusting God. Which time we did not do. But you have to sow in the morning. You sow in the afternoon. You sow at night. Any opportunity you have to sow, keep on sowing. I remember one time that the GO was ministering. We said, okay, you know what? We need to sow. Praise the Lord. You keep on sowing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He did not quit, even though the birds get some. The second thing that told me that this man, he did not quit, was the seed. Some of them fell on rocky ground. The rocky ground is not of your making. Yours is that you just keep on sowing. I was discussing with my friend that came from Nigeria one time. I started telling me about some of the land he bought and how some of all these landowners or Monile came and fought on the land. And of course, but it did not allow that to stop him from buying more. Mm. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Those are rocky ground because you put the money there and before you know it, it's gone. But you don't say because of that, you stop. The same thing in ministry. You invite somebody, you give somebody flyers, they did not show up. We don't say because of that we'll go stop. Or you pray, God did not answer that prayer at that particular time. Or it seems as if God did not answer. That does not mean that you are going to stop praying. Praise the Lord. The sower keep on sowing. Why will he keep on sowing? He has to discipline his what? Disappointment. In life, you will be disappointed, but you don't allow that to put you there. The seed falls on turning ground. And of course, he was so excited. We skipped one. When they fall on rocky ground, some of them actually spring forth. But before you know it, there was hot weather. And Bible says that they dried off. Some of them will come. They will stay. They will germinate. But before you know it, there might be hot weather. And they will fall aside. Maybe they think, okay, this could be where I can hide my dirty things. And when they come, it's not according to the expectation. Sometimes some might think, okay, it's just a place for me to just jamboree and just know solid word of God. But the word is coming undiluted and they cannot absorb it. Some can dry and just drop out. What are we saying? That does not make the sower to stop sowing. Because Some will stay and some will not just stay. Praise the Lord. Finally, the seed falls on good ground. Should I tell somebody here this morning that it will always do? It will always do. It will always do. I don't know, maybe the person you marry right now is the first person you ever dated. But some, it's not like that. You dated the first person, or you think that this girl will be the woman, and before you know it, she just came to you one day and said, Holy Spirit is leading me to that brother that has Benz. I say, Sister Joyce, I thought we are vision together. Praise the Lord. You are dating another one, and you see pastor, it's possible you have even seen each other's family. All of a sudden, before you know it, might be the brother this time around, or this another sister again. I just tell you, praise the Lord, brother, help me rejoice. I just see my new fancy is in the UK. But eventually, you will eventually get married, right? The same thing when you have a good ideas and you keep sharing it with people. You keep sharing with people. You keep sharing it with people. People with positive mind. Should I tell somebody, it will surely fall on a good soil one day. Amen. And it will grow. We are praying. We are bringing people. You just put a flyer. These flyers will eventually fall on a good soil one day. And the person needs Christ, and we find she or he will find himself or herself in church. Praise the Lord. Amen. The seed finally grow. If you keep on sowing, it will grow. And when it grows, it will not grow at the same speed. It will not grow at the same speed. Some will do 30% as scripture described. Some will do 60% and some will do 100%. I bought some stocks back home then, due to recession or whatever it is called, either human recession or economy recession. The stocks, they are nowhere to be found again. Would I say that would be the end of me buying into shares or buying stock? No. But you have to research where to buy. People of God, if there's nothing you get from this morning message, know that the seed will always grow. This church as we are is a seed that has been planted, and it will grow.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know that vision that God has given to you and you keep nurturing. It's a seed. It will grow. In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
I don't know that income that is in your hand. And you pray, sometimes it's not even enough. It's not, in fact, it doesn't even cover the cost of the bread. Talk less about removing the seed from it. But you have to know that part of the seed from that little income is your tithe. I mean, by God's special grace, we'll go through some series of teaching and training and administration on financial empowerment in this church. There's a formula, we call it 70-10-10-10. The 10%, as small as it could be, belongs to God. Then the 10% belongs to you. You can invest it, sow it as a seed towards future, or you save it. Then the other 10%, you plant it or save it. Then you are free to spend the 70%. But what we do, sometimes we think the 100 is not even enough. We don't give God the 10%. We don't give ourselves the 10%. And what normally happens is the general formula that people use is, I will save after I have finished paying my debt, after I have finished paying the bills. But the problem in that formula is, after you have finished paying the bills and the debt, in most cases you don't even finish. There's nothing remains. So you keep going and you are not paying yourself anything.
Wow! I hope you've been mightily blessed from today's ministration. I'm so glad that you are here, and tell you what, we do not take this time for granted at all. We would like to hear from you. Share your testimony with us on our website, www.rccgage.org. You can also post on our Facebook page, follow us on Twitter, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and you can also follow us on Instagram. And if you happen to live in our neighborhood, we would like to have you worship with us. We are located at 3226 Pioneer Road, Suite C, Boss Spring, Texas, 75180. Until next time, on Abundant Grace Hour, remember, His grace is sufficient for you.